Hey, what's going on, guys? I am John from JFM Development, and today I'm going to show you how to make a basic RDA build for beginners. Because in DIY, you need to know how to do that so you can do some flavor testing. So I wanted to put something basic on here. It's not going to be anything extreme. It's just going to be a good middle-to-the-road coil on a great RDA to begin with. And it's what I recommend to get started. And today, doing that, we're going to use the Coil Master kit. This video is in no way sponsored by them, but it is a very convenient kit, and I'm going to get more into that in a second, so stay tuned. All right, what's going on, guys? So today I want to show you how to make a basic build for your first RDA. It took me a lot of thought in how I wanted to teach you how to do this. So I came up with the general rule of thumb to get you started building on your own RDA. So today I'm going to show you how to build a basic build. Something that's good, that's in the middle range of ohms. Something that's sub ohms. Something that's in the middle. It's not too low. It's not too high. It's kind of in the Goldilocks zone. It should be just right. But the first thing I'm probably going to suggest, if you're going to get into rebuilding RDAs, it doesn't cost much money and it gives you everything you're going to need to get started, and that's the Coil Master kit right here. And the reason why I'm suggesting the Coil Master kit is, sure, you could have your own little tools, or one tool here, one tool there, but just having everything in one little nice spot kind of really helps things out. And now, this video is in no way sponsored by Coil Master. I bought this with my own money, but I use it all the time. It keeps my stuff all organized. I don't lose tools. It's just in this easy zip-up case. I really like it, and I definitely recommend it. So, what this kit comes with is, it comes with a pair of snippers. And this will help cut your wire. Comes with a pair of pliers right here. Helps you grab hold of your wires. I'm not going to take everything out. Some of it's pretty self-explanatory. It comes with a Phillips head screwdriver. And also the Phillips head screwdriver has some indents on it. And that will gauge just how big diameter coil you have. So that comes in handy too. But it's also a Phillips head screwdriver. Next one is kind of the same, except for it's a flathead screwdriver. Okay. Now, here are some of the most important tools you're going to have in this kit right here. First one is ceramic tweezers. Now, these tweezers are excellent for when you're building coils, because they're going to help you pinch and glow your coils. And it's not going to short out because the tips are ceramic. So these are very important to have. Another very important set of tweezers. Tweezers are your best friend when you're building RDAs. Now these are perfect. It's at an angle. And what that does is it allows you to put your cotton in. I use this all the time for my cotton, which you're going to see here. Also, the kit, when you get it brand new, it comes with maybe 10 feet of wire. Yeah, 10 feet of wire and 24 gauge. I already used it. I haven't refilled it. But it comes with 10 feet of 24 gauge canthal wire, which is a good wire to start off with. Also, these that didn't come with, these are just for my RDA, but it does have this empty spot here where you can put two 18650 batteries. Also right here for your cotton and trimming it, comes with some scissors. These are really cool. Alright. Now over here, I don't use it too much. There's a newer version of this kit that comes with a way better one that allows you to actually glow your coils. But this is just an ohms meter. It'll test the ohms of your coil. But I'm going to use my mod for that purpose because this one doesn't allow you to glow your coils. But if you're to get the updated Coil Master kit, it does have a better ohms meter and it will allow you to glow. It'll allow you to glow your coils. So, and this right here is the coil jig set. Basically, it'll also have a little Allen wrench too, which I broke mine, but it'll come with the Allen wrench and it will come with all these different rods at different gauge sizes. So see, one says 15, that's 1.5 millimeter. The 20 is a 2 millimeter. The 25 is a 2.5 milliliter. Millimeter. Can't get it out right. But basically, they're just the rods like that that you put into the coil jig. So today we're going to be doing 2.5 milliliter. Millimeter. So we're going to use the one that says 25 on it. Okay? So we're going to grab that. We're going to grab this coil jig right here. If you look at this, it has this little top end cap unscrews right here, and that's where you feed your wire through, one on that side and then one through that side. You'll see what I'm talking about. So first you want to unscrew this coil jig. And you're going to want to take that rod right here and just place it through that hole. And then take this and screw it in. Like that. It's very simple. And now you're going to want to take the corresponding jig tool piece right here. And you're going to want to use the side that says, you're going to want to use the side that says 25. Okay? So now we're going to need to get some wire to get this started. So we're going to do a 0.5 ohm build. And this Cantal wire is cheap. I bought it off Amazon, but there are so many different places where you can buy your Cantal. It's completely up to you. So I'm going to get the snips handy. So I'm going to be kind of liberal with this. I'm going to take a couple wraps off. One, two. I'll take three, one more, just in case. Although that's probably more than enough. And I'm just going to snip the wire. Okay. So now we're done with that. Now I'm going to take this wire and I'm going to cut this wire in half. I'm just going to cut it in half, like so. Now we should have two pieces of wire, okay? Because we're going to have to do this twice. Vape break. That's another thing about coil building, too. You're going to want to have your vape nearby. Be able to vape. All that other stuff. Take your time. Have fun with it. Hopefully you have a spare vape and you're not just using an RDA. Okay, so now here's one of the important things you need to know. Okay, see how there is two holes right there? Okay, take one of the pieces of wire and stick it in that hole, and it's gonna come out like that. Okay, and then you just take your finger and just hold that wire. Okay, that's all you need to know. And then you're gonna want to kind of bend the wire the first time, just along that pole so it goes down, okay? Just straight down. So see what I'm talking about? See how I just bent it over that wire, over the pole once? That's all you want to do, okay? And now, you're going to want to take this tool on the side that says 25, okay, and you're going to want to just put it on top. Hold on, let me get it focused. See how there's a hole in there? You just stick it over the rod like that, okay? And now if you look closely, you see how there's that little nub right there? That's going to spin the coil. So you're just going to want to twist. Hold on, let me focus hard on it. Okay. So see how that there's that little nub right there? You're just going to want to spin, okay? And to do a 0.5 ohm coil with a 24 gauge, we're going to do 12 wraps. I think 12 wraps should get us there. Okay? So we're just going to spin it 12 times. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. And you're just going to want to do a half turn. And now it should give you like the perfect edge right there. Now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to clip this side. Like so. You're going to want to take this off. Just pull it straight off. And what you want to do is you want to flip the coil around. Okay. You're just going to want to pull. I'm going to get the pliers. Here's where the pliers come in handy. Okay, so you're just going to want to hold the coil with one hand and then take that wire and just pull. There you go, it should straighten out. Clean up your leads a little bit. There you go, and you have your first basic coil right there. Now you're just going to want to build one more of those. So let's do it exactly the same way. We're going to take it, put it through there, bend it, hold it with this finger, bend the first lead, like so. I'm going to try to do this lower to the ground so I can get this around the camera without hitting it with the wire. Actually, better yet, I'm going to clip some of this wire. We don't need that much. Because I want to be able to get it better for you. Okay. So you kind of want to make sure this is straight a little bit, if you can. Or as straight as you can get it. Now I'm just going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to put it like this. Just let it hit the first time so the wire catches like right there. Then just wrap it 12 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. Just going on, make sure you do a half turn. And then there you go, you got that perfect edge on that side. Just pull it over, flip the coil around, put it back on the rod. And then you take your pliers and your lead and you just pull it straight towards you. And there you go. You just clean up the leads a little bit. It doesn't have to be perfect because it's just going to go in your atomizer and you're going to end up cutting those. Usually you want to keep one lead bigger than the other. I mean, that's still a little bit big. But also make sure you compare your coils. Make sure you did wrap them the same amount. Yep. See, this should be perfect. You want to make sure you wrap the same amount of coils on each coil. Otherwise, one's going to burn at a different rate than the other, okay? So they won't glow at the same rate, and you won't get a good vape. You'll get some burnt cotton taste, okay? So that's very important. So now that we have these 12 wrap on a 25 or 2.5 millimeter bit, now we're ready to install these. So let's take them off. First, I'm going to cut down these leads, though, a little bit more because it's still a little bit big to be putting in an RDA. There you go. You just want to make sure one is bigger than the other, and then that should do fine. It should do fine. And they don't have to be perfectly even because you're just going to go in and you're probably going to cut all the way up to there. So that's not going to matter. So we have those two coils all set right there. You're still going to want to keep your snips handy. You're going to want these. Actually, you're going to want a lot of that handy. So I'm just going to put this over here a little bit. Now here's the RDA. Today, the RDA we're using is the Troll, okay? The Troll version 2 RDA. I love this RDA. It's a very good RDA for the money. I do definitely suggest it. Now what I like to do is I like to take a screwdriver, okay? And I like to put the coil on the screwdriver and use this to kind of center and put in my coils. Now this specific RDA uses an Allen key, and that's why I have these in my set, because a lot of my RDAs do use Allen keys, and that's what they're good for, okay? But this is also why I suggest this deck to start off with. This is called the Velocity Style deck. It's pretty straightforward. You just put your lead straight in, it automatically centers it for you, and you just tighten them up. So it's perfect. So pretty much I'm going to take, there's two leads here, okay? See the first one and the second one? I'm going to put the first one in the bottom one, and the second one in the top one. Like that, okay? See what I did just there? I put the bottom lead on the bottom and the top lead at the top, and you're just going to push in, okay? And what you want to do is you want to make sure you're centered and you're not going to hit the side. So you want to make sure you're in the circumference of that circle there, so you're not going to hit it with the cap, because otherwise that will ground out. Also, you're going to want to go to the side and make sure that it's even with the posts, all right? But also at the same time, you do want to get it as close to the side as possible, but without it touching. That way you get more airflow, and the more airflow, the better the vape, okay? So that's what you want to do, just like that, and I'm going to tighten it up right here. You just take your Allen key and you tighten up these leads. Let's see where it is. I like to tighten a little bit at a time on both sides, that way I kind of like torque them, but without like moving the coil. And then you just want to make sure it's centered, like so. See how it's centered? And I pull it, and then if you go over here, you just want to make sure it's even. See how it's even? That's exactly what you want. So it's centered in the middle. Now if you look up top, it's not going to touch. I might want to move that just over a little bit. So what you do is you put your screwdriver in on the opposite side where you want to move it. And you just push a little bit like that and pull. And there you go. That's pretty center. Looks pretty good to me. Alright, and now you take your snips. And you just cut off the excess leads. Like so. Get really close up there. And just cut. Same over here. Really close up. Oops. Okay. And just cut. Bingo, bingo, boom. Now you do the exact same to the other side. And see, actually, I'm going to show you without using the screwdriver. You don't even have to use the screwdriver. You can straighten it up once you do it. But basically, you're going to want to make sure that the coil is in decently. And kind of use your finger just to hold it there. And I'm going to show you how you can pull it into place. Okay. So see how I didn't use a screwdriver and it came out a little bit bent? That's no problem. Now this is the time where you do use a screwdriver. You just place it in and you just pull it towards you. And it will even right up. And you just kind of just play with it, adjust it. There we go. She's looking pretty, guys. She's looking pretty. If you look over here, you might just want to even that out a little bit. Okay. Looking good, guys. Looking good. Alright, now I'm going to take the snips and cut off the excess again. Boom, boom. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the cap and just test it, make sure it fits. So it does. Comes off. Didn't move the coils at all. Now it's time to glue them. But what I like to do first is, usually this is the point where you would put it on an ohms meter to check the ohms, but I don't have an ohms meter that actually can glow the coils. So this pretty much does the same thing if you put it on a regulated mod. Now there are very different ways to go about it and different theories, but I think using a mod is fine. It does tell you the ohms, so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to press the power button once. What it's going to do is going to tell you the ohms depending on the mod. This one says it's 0.42, so it's close. So 12 wraps on 24 gauge is going to give you 0.42 ohms. So it's almost 0.50 ohms. So you'd probably want to put one more wrap on each. So it'd probably be 13 wraps, not 12. I don't really make too many of these basic ones anymore. But if you guys do want some more advanced builds in the future, definitely let me know. I can show you those too. But this is a good middle of the road one to get you started. So now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to glow the coils. But what you probably want to do is you probably want to lower the watts. I'll do this around 40 watts. Everybody has their own way of doing this, but I think 40 watts is fine. What you're going to want to do is pulse your coils. Now when you do this, you're going to want to have your tweezers handy. So you can pinch and strum your coils. I'm more of a strummer than a pincher, but sometimes pinching can come in handy. Alright, so let's get this started. I'm just going to pulse it. Okay, see how it's glowing unevenly? So I'm just going to strum. Just going to rub the back of the tweezers against the coil. I'm going to do it again. Just keep pinching. And look at that, guys. We're already there. See that? Alright. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce more wattage. Go to 80. Alright, now we're going to glow again. And look at that. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Alright, so now we got to put some cotton on it. Now for the cotton today, we're going to use some cotton bacon. You can use whatever cotton you like. I use cotton bacon. I have been using cotton bacon. It works fine for me. I've used all different sorts of stuff before, but I kind of really like cotton bacon. And cotton bacon just comes in these strips right here. You're going to want to kind of eye it. You're going to want to like kind of pull your cotton apart so it gets kind of thin. Until you have like this like thin layer. This is how I do it. Other people might do it differently. So this amount right here is probably plenty enough. And then you're just going to want to take it and just kind of rip a strip off. Like that. So you just have this and that. And what I do is I take it and I start rolling it. Just start rolling it. It's a little bit weird to do with gloves on, but I figured using gloves in the video would be more professional. But you do want to make sure you have clean hands when you are handling the cotton, because the oils in your skin will get on the cotton and it doesn't taste good. Okay, so now that it's pretty rolled up, like you see, like that. Hold on, let's see if I can. So it's pretty rolled up. The fibers are kind of activated, which is kind of what you want. And you're going to want to twist one side. Okay, so I'm just twisting it just so I have something to put through the coils. Okay, and then you get something like that, okay? And what you can do is you can use just one side and then just put it in through both sides. Or you can put it in one coil, cut the ends off, and then use the other ends. But I'm going to do it this way. I usually do it both ways, but this way it will save some time. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to put the cotton in through the coil. Then you're going to want to take your hand, take the other side, and just pull it through. So I'm going to do it down here so it's easier. There you go. Pull it through. You're going to want to make sure it's snug, but it's not too snug. That should be perfect. And then I'm going to take those little handy dandy scissors that we have. And the way I measure it is I put the cotton, I take my finger, I put it to the edge right there. Okay? And then see where the bottom is? I put the scissors on the deck and I just cut. And then that way I know it'll reach all the way to the bottom of the juice well, like that, okay? And then I'm going to do the exact same thing for this side. I'm just going to put the cotton down like that, okay? I'm going to take the scissors and cut. All right, so now we just do the same thing again. We're going to roll it. Just rolling the cotton. And I hope you guys don't mind I'm not doing too much editing with this one, because I want you guys to see how it really is to make a coil for the first time. Well, it's not my first time, but how you guys would be making a coil in real time. Alright, and then you just pull it through like before. There you go. Just want to make sure it's snug. Okay, and then just do the same thing. Kind of bolt off at the base. Like so. Now you see you have cotton on both sides. Now what you can do is you take your tweezers. Don't drop them. Okay. You take your tweezers, and you're just going to want to kind of fluff your cotton a little bit. I mean, you don't really have to do this step because we already kind of fluffed it when I rolled it the way I did. But you just fluff it a little bit. Kind of just like agitating the cotton a little bit. That's all you're doing. Opens up the fibers. Not really much to it. Alright, and then what you do is you just take the bottom of the cotton like so. And you're just gonna put it in the cup. In the cup. That's all you do. Just put it in the cup and just make sure it's off to the side. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that there's air that's going to go underneath the coil. That's very important to make sure there's air going through that coil. So we do the same thing on this side. Going to take the edge of the cotton. I'm just going to place it in the cup. See? Placing it in the cup. That's all you do. And you just clean it up. Clean it up. And again, just make sure you keep that middle open. Kind of like that. See? It's really not too tough once you get used to it. If I wasn't showing you this on a camera, I could do it in like 2 seconds, but I want to try to make sure I get some good angles for you. Okay, so again, this side. Take the cotton, stuff it in the cup. Be gentle with it though, because you want to keep those fibers like activated so it absorbs juice well. So just go slow, be patient. Especially your first time. And you know what? You're going to be changing cotton out so much. You're going to get so much practice. Just keep at it. Just try not to overpack the cotton. And try not to do too little cotton. You kind of need to be just right. But just know, cotton kind of works like a sponge. So if you get it all nice and fluffy, you're not going to need as much as if you just like really put down, pack down cotton. And there you go. Alright. Now see how you have the air going through each side? Now what's going to happen is the air side flow, you're going to want to make sure you put the airflow right on top of the coil. So see how the airflow, it's going to be right in front of the coil. That's what you want to make sure you always do when you have an RDA. So let's wick it. Sorry, I took a vape in the middle of it. So how about you, let's use some of that that strawberry fog mix we just made yesterday. Stuff's really good. So what you want to do when you wick these coils is you're going to want to kind of just put it right over the coil. Just go slow, just a little bit over the coils to begin with. You might want to put a couple drops on the bottom because that way it'll start some juice absorbing through the bottom. You're going to kind of want to just keep putting it over the top. Once you did it a couple times, you can start like dry firing it a little bit. That way it'll suck right in the coil. So now I'm going to just press it a couple times, just lightly. And that way it will suck in the juice. Oops, sorry. Okay. Dry fire. Just do it easily. You don't hold it down too long. Just a little bit, just so it sucks in the juice. And you just want to make sure everything's saturated. And the best part too is once the wicks are wet, you can more manipulate them better to how you want them. So if you need to clean the wicks up a little bit. And you just dab a little bit on the sides. Just be gentle and dab. Dab, dab, dab. pretty much all there is to it. The best part about this one too is it has a huge juice well. It's huge, so you can get a lot of rips off of it if you fill up this juice well. Alright, now let's check it out. You ready? Vapors. Alright. I'm gonna put the cap on and we'll go back up and we'll vape on it. Vape on it. There she is, guys. We're ready. Alright, I'll meet you back up top and we'll vape on it. Okay guys, so I hope this whole tutorial has helped you new people out a little bit. I mean, I just want to put something out there that would really help beginners. It's a good middle to the road, you know, 0.5 ohm coil. That's a good middle of the road for RDA, especially for our first build. Now, you don't need this whole kit in order to make a coil. You can just take a drill bit or a small screwdriver and wrap 12 to 13 wraps around that to get around 0.5 ohms. But this kit is very inexpensive and it has everything you need to get started in building your own coils. And also, I mean, if you don't want to go through all of that, you can end up getting like something like this. This is just a whole bunch of coils already pre-made. And all you'd have to do is just install them yourself. And you don't have to go about wrapping your own coils. But I just have this for when I'm feeling lazy. Otherwise, I just build my own coils. If you guys do want some more, you know, more in-depth coil builds, I will definitely do them. I mean, I'm not the end-all, be-all coil maker. I'm not no own boy. I'm not no extraterrestrial coil maker. I'm just kidding. I know they're aliens. So I was just joking. But I can make stuff like claptons, fused claptons, twisted wires, and, you know, some more intricate builds. But, you know, I'm not the best, but I can get my own thing done to provide for my own needs. So, less yapping. Let's vape this thing, okay? I like to vape at high wattages. So I'm going to vape this at 90 watts. If I can get there. Okay. So 90 watts, we have that strawberry fog we just dripped in there. Let's see how it goes. Excellent. You see, this Troll RDA, I honestly believe it's one of the best RDAs to get you started with. It has a nice velocity style deck. The airflow is wonderful. It has a huge juice well. And best yet, you can get it for under 30 bucks. So that's a steal of a deal. It's a great way to get started. Inexpensive. It's not going to break the bank. And it will allow you to flavor test your liquids, which is why I wanted this whole video on this channel, because I need to have an RDA video, because the main important thing about DIY is you're actually able to flavor test, and you really can't do that in tanks. You have to have an RDA. So that's good stuff, guys. So I hope you liked this little tutorial. I know it was kind of messy. It's really hard to film coil making, so I definitely give props to the people who have done it better than me. But I just wanted to have like an unedited thing to show you how. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you like this video, please put a like on it. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe. You have plenty of DIY content and maybe more content like this in the future if that's what you guys want. And put a like on the video. And you guys have yourselves a great day. Peace.